Hey everybody, I'm gonna do this the best I can. My heart is very full right now. After all the beautiful comments, prayers offered, practical care. We are so dependent right now on everybody. Nobody feels like doing anything. But God, He's feeding us through you. He's encouraging us through you. And we don't feel good at all. We have good moments here and there, and so feel pretty good right now. After finally being able to go to sleep after a lot of hours, something occurred in the hospital this morning with me, and it was really scary. But God, and I'm so grateful. I don't know what God's will is exactly in this season, but I'm learning to trust His heart towards His children. He loves us so much, and I choose God every day, no matter what. I'm going to, I'm starting to think that this may be, this time and journey may be why Prevailing with Patricia was initiated. And so I'm going to share this process. I made one video upon my release this morning. But now this video is to say thank you. If I could tell you how much your comments and prayers mean right now, to read them, to scroll through them and get encouraged by so much love. It's community, it's God's kingdom in operation. And it brings strength. Mom's sleeping right now a lot. And bear with me, I have headaches pretty bad. And Mom and I have the same patterns. It seems that I had it first because I'm about 3 days advanced over her. So the Lord has really showed me how to help coach her through what I've been through. So we went to the hospital yesterday because Mom wanted to go. And it was her, one of her worst days so far. She says her words are that she feels lousy. I have to be honest with you. It's scary. It's scary. But we're not choosing to fear. We're choosing to trust God no matter how we feel. I've got a lot to share about what happened to me in the hospital when Dad brought Mom home. Close family friend was with dad, and dad, I told mom that we were in the same room at one point, and they put me in the bed for care, and mom had to sit up in her walker. And I said, "Mom, you can go home. You don't have to wait all those hours for me." And so she was so, we're so exhausted. It's very tiring, and I'm 48, and I'm wore out and can't hardly function. I can get up and make it to the restroom and go to the front door to get the drop offs, but I'm not doing much more than that. And I'm wore out, and Mama's 79 or 80. Lord, I can't remember how old she is right now. Oof. Anyway, when I was there at the hospital by myself, something happened in the COVID unit, and it really scared me. And I'm gonna tell it later. I encourage you not to take your loved ones to the hospital unless you really have to. There are things going on spiritually. There are demonic spirits that are snatching people's lives. Yeah, it happened to me, but God. And I wasn't even in that bad of a shape. Like I was recovering. This COVID, there's a lot of evil spirits connected to this. And when that happened, there was so much fear that came over me. I told him, "You release me now. I'm going home now." Our loved ones are going to the hospital. And these hell holes, there's spiritual demonic portals at the hospital. I know it sounds crazy, but I am not hallucinating. God allowed me to experience it. I've always been one to ask a lot of questions and be very observant. Anyway, I'm trying to rest because I'm at a whatever strand of COVID that we have. There's different strands, right? Different levels and intensities. Mom and I have the same patterns. So right now I'm in a phase where I can't go to sleep. So whenever I have to really focus to try to even go to sleep. The devil's trying to steal my rest, and I need rest to get stronger. Anyway, I don't want to talk too long. I've got a lot to share, and I'm gonna be real with you. God loves us. His love towards us is so perfect. These hellhounds and demons that are part of the kingdom of darkness have been behind this COVID, and fear feeds the COVID. When I went through that experience, I was so scared and I got so fearful, but I knew to pray. And the Holy Spirit just began to pray through me. I prayed in the Spirit. And I told him, "You discharge me now." Like the devil's demons is using COVID units to snatch people's lives out of here. It happened. He tried it with me. And guess what? I can't say it's even the devil, but it was like a demon, death demon that just, whoo, and I said, I jolted. I like immediately jolted. And I said, "Devil, you were trying to kill me." And I said, "God, this is so scary." And I jumped out of that. I jumped out of that bed. And I began to pray I wouldn't get back in that bed. Those COVID units are like portals of demon activity. They're snatching our lives of our loved ones. God revealed a lot to me today. God is working on some stuff. Y'all, pray. Pray. Repent. Repent of sins. God loves us so much. He loves us so much. Like the devil was trying to keep us from understanding the love of God. He values us and loves us so much. And a lot of stuff that's been happening, we've been getting mad at God and blaming God. And it's been the evil one in the world. It's been the kingdom of darkness behind it, not God. But God, if we put our trust in him, he can turn bad things and use them for good, for our good. He can bring real beauty out of it. I'm going to document this process. I have determined that if this is my purpose in life, I'm going to give it all I got. God showed me some beautiful stuff today that he is doing for his people. And some people don't even realize they're his people. Like, he loves us so much. Anyway, my heart is really full because of your care. Your care, your comments, your prayers overwhelmed my heart. I'm going to share it with my parents tomorrow. It's going to be my focus for the day tomorrow. It's just to read the comments to my parents. That's going to be my work for tomorrow. Lord, say the same. I'm going to try to lay down and get some sleep. Pray that I can go to sleep and rest, especially after that experience this morning in the hospital. I'm kind of scared to go to sleep, honestly, but I'm putting that in God's hands. And I gotta go to sleep at some point. And moms, the prayer request for mom is that she will eat and drink when you don't feel like eating and drinking. And that she would get up and try to walk. So mine is to learn how to rest through all of this and go to sleep. And like, I lay in the bed and I try to sleep, but enemy's trying to steal my rest, and I need rest to get stronger. And mom again needs mom needs to get up and try to walk every couple hours or so, and to eat and drink when she don't feel like it. You don't really feel like eating and drinking. But we have to stay hydrated, and y'all know I don't like water, so I have to drink water to live and flood this mess out. Anyway, I think I've been on here long enough. I'm gonna post this one. Thank you so much. We love you, man. Y'all don't understand how much the support means. Woo! I don't know how we would make it. We're depending on other people strong right now. As far as prayers for my dad is engulfed with this virus in our household, and I would say pray his courage in the Lord. Dad can't really wait on us because he's not in good shape. But he say he ain't got the virus. He ain't getting the virus. And anyway, pray for Dad to continue with courage, because I'm praying that he don't have to go through what Mom and I feel. I'm going to post the other video of my release this morning, where I got a lot to share when it's time and God's teaching me some stuff. And, I trust God. I trust his character, his love towards his people. And, this is real. Because this is what took out my Aunt Chris and my first cousin, Trisha. This is so real. And grief is a part of it too. Because being in the hospital and going through all these triggers. But we choose to submit it to God too. We gonna make it. We on the winning team. So, okay, I think I've been on here long enough. I need to really try to go to sleep. Love y'all. Keep praying and covering us. We are very dependent on your prayers and on hot meals and supplies right now. Thank you.